That's facts. Big blue bills in the bank. Let's chat. I just hit a mill like a baseball bat. I just bought 100,000 off the Glad van. I'm a big deal, like my name all caps. That's facts. That's facts. That's facts. That's facts. Good morning, good evening, good night, everybody. Depending on the time you see this, I am Taylor, and with another episode of Taylor Said, but this is more so like an aha moment. Yesterday in church, I happened to be texting my sister in Christ and kind of explaining to her or asking her, did she see about those new shoes that got blood and blah, 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 basically demon scent. And, you know, we get to on texting and we got on to Cardi B. So I was explaining to her, oh, I don't like her because her thing is my babies will never listen to my music because I know it's no good for me, but yet it's out here polluting, you know, everyone else. Yes, I get it. It's our job to control our kids, but we can't be with them 24/7 or control everything that runs across them, whatever. So in the mix of us texting, she texts, she is the music. So, of course, I don't know if it was her or if it was the Holy Spirit saying, whoa, what is it that you are doing that we think we are hiding from our kids, we are hiding from the society, we are hiding from our husbands, we are hiding from whatever the case may be, and we are that. When we do something so much, it becomes us. It consumes us. She is her music. All the ups and press and all this other extra stuff that she sings, that's her. It's hard to hide you from your kids to say, hey, they won't do XYZ because they never listen to it, but we're not thinking, I am what I'm doing. That is me. So I couldn't even text back because I'm like, that is us. We, for our parents, aunties, motivational speakers, pastors, leaders, husbands, wives, whatever you are, whatever position you have, and whatever you're doing that you feel like, I'm hiding such and such from such and such because you're protecting them. At the end of the day, you're not. You are that. You are that cheater. You are that liar. You are that music. You are that manipulator. You are whatever you feel like you cannot tell to the person you love or the person you're trying to get out of a certain situation. You are that addiction. Regardless if nobody sees it or not, regardless if no one sees you taking up that alcohol, you are that alcoholic. That is you. The very thing that we seem to hide or we try to run from or we try to feel like I'm going to do this on my personal time and nobody's going to see it, that's you. You're that thing and you're not hiding from nobody, and we're definitely not hiding it from God. We seem to think if my kids don't know, if my job don't know, if my friends don't know, if my husband don't know, if whatever, my siblings don't know, my parents don't know, I'm okay. I can do it on the side because we have this thing of saying, if they don't see me do it, I'm not crushing them. And a lot of times it's not about the people. Yeah, you may think, okay, I could be hypocritical. I can tell this person not to curse because it's not good. It's not ladylike. It's not manlike. You can't get into society that way, but I'm gonna be a cusser at home. That's you. You are that cursor. So when she hit me with she is her music, it was like, oh my goodness, what are we doing that we feel like we're hiding from people? What are we doing that we feel like, okay, as long as my kids don't see me do this, I'm good. As long as my husband never catch me, I'm good. As long as my wife don't see me doing this, I'm okay. As long as my friends can never tell, I'm fine. It's not true, you all. You are the very thing that you can't tell the world. That is you. It don't consume you so much that it got you thinking, they don't know. It would never hurt nobody. It would never hurt me because nobody that I love or nobody that I'm trying to get up out of a slump or my motivational, my mentor, my mentees, my teachers, they don't know I'm doing it. It's a lie. Sometimes people could just look at you and tell she's a smoker. That girl got a bad attitude. That boy ain't no good. He ain't really got no money. That's you. You are that very thing. So we got to get out of trying to stop hiding stuff or trying to stop doing the very things that we know we should not be doing just because for whatever odd reason we done got so consumed with it that we feel like it make us feel good. It takes away the stress. I could just cuss one little words. It's just words that mean something else. I can just go ahead and sleep with him for a little bit because nobody knows. You're that person. You're that thing that you are hiding. It consumed you so much that it got you feeling like you're sneaky. Adam and Eve that ate the apple trying to hide behind a bush, and he see us. Most importantly, God see you. So we got to stop trying to live for other people and really look deep into ourselves. We do things because we're saying, I don't want them to make me feel XYZ. I don't want people to know that this is what I do. And at the end of the day, we got to understand for ourselves. It does, you are, your stress did not go away because you hit that joint. It's still there. Your wife is not going to stop nagging you because you grabbed that beer. She's still going to talk junk. Your kids are not going to be any less perfect or any more perfect because they don't know you, because they're still going to end up, because you're bringing that spirit to your home. So we got to start praying more. We got to start being honest with ourselves. We got to start saying, what is it that I am? What do my energy bring out to this world that I don't think it brings out? People sometimes feel you before you open your mouth, before they see the joint, before they hear the curse word, before they see you with somebody else's wife. They feel it, because that's you. You are that very thing you're trying to hide, but still do. You are that. So we start understanding, I'm that. I'm that person. I'm that thing. I'm that object. I'm that whatever it is that I would not want my kids to do. I would not want society to do. I would not want my pastor to know. I would not want my congregation to know. I don't want the people in my circle to know. That is you. And if you're okay with being that person, look deep down inside and really, really meditate on that. If you're okay with being that backslider every other month, hey, who am I? All I can say is meditate on it really, really deep down and think about what is it that you're doing and why you're hiding it. And if you're hiding it from people or from something, it's because it's not okay. So I wanted to come on with a very snip clip of, what are you? Who are you? Not the person you show everybody, not the things that your kids think you are, not your congregation. When you look in the mirror, the thing that you're hiding, what are you? Thank you all for watching the video. I really hope we got something out of it. If you're like me, there's sometimes we think we're hiding things because it's not so much of we're ashamed of it, or because we don't want to hurt the people around us. You know, we learn in life that not everything is meant to be seen, not everything is meant to be shown. So we act accordingly because you don't want to hurt someone, you don't want to send someone down the wrong path. But at the end of the day, those spirits walk with you. At the end of the day, whatever happens in the dark will come out in the light. And if it's something that you can't explain, or if it's something that's really, really bad, or you're really hiding it, or you know it's gonna hurt somebody, we gotta learn to let it go. We gotta really talk deep into ourselves and say, is it worth it? Is it worth one day God coming to shake this up and to spread my business? Is it worth the wrath of God? Is it worth hurting whomever, or is it worth lying to myself? We gotta really look into the mirror and say, that's me. I'm that. And now let's start changing our minds. Let's start talking over ourselves and saying, I will know more. It's going to be hard. It's going to be a struggle. We get so comfortable with things that it becomes the norm, and that norm is not okay. So get uncomfortable, shake up a little bit, start speaking to yourself and telling you to stop. Start confessing the very thing that you don't want anyone to know. Start living a little better for yourself, not for no one else, but for you. Start understanding what I am doing is not okay. I am that, and I can change that. It's okay. We all have our flaws or our sins or our, I don't know, our boo-boos that we do that we should not be doing because we know better. Let's change it now. It's never too late to turn around, no matter how old or how young or how far or how deep you are into it. It's never too late to say, stop. That thing that's in the back of your head that you're saying, I don't think this is okay, but I like it. I don't think I should be doing this, but it feels good. I don't know if this is okay. Nobody's never gonna know, but I know. You know what you're doing. You know what you shouldn't be doing. So let's get better, you all. Let's start sending out that energy, that aura, that spirit that we know that should be out there. Let's change for us. Not for me, not for your mama, not for your kids, not for your mentors or mentees, for you. Really look into yourself and say, 5 years from now, is this worth it? Am I going to be stuck in the same place because I don't got comfortable? Am I going to make any difference in my life? Am I going to walk with purpose doing this stuff? And if it's no to either one of those answers, let it go. No matter how fun, how joyful, how whatever it makes you feel, let it go. In the long run, it's going to backfire. It's going to hurt you or somebody else. And the last thing you want to do is be a crutch to your life. is be the reason why you're not moving forward, is be the reason why you're stuck in the same place or you're under what you could have been. So let's change our minds, you all. Let's look into the mirror. Let's talk to ourselves. Let's speak positive to ourselves, and let's tell ourselves it's okay to let go. As right now we're saying, I am that. In a couple months, say, I'm not that anymore. I'm no longer that. I will not be that anymore. I cannot continue doing that for myself or for anybody else. So let's move forward. Let's change our mind. And the theme of our church title is Victory Over My Mind. And let's do just that. Let's win, y'all. Let's win for ourselves and nobody else. You can do it. And as always, I love you, and so do God.